In this video, I'm going to show you guys multiple different ways you can make your microphone sound professional.
Honestly speaking, my audio quality isn't so amazing, but the tips that I'm going to be sharing in this video have really helped my audio sound much better, are insanely actionable, and are completely free.
With that being said, let's get right into the video. Tip number one, this is really important. Make sure you're using the best microphone settings before you record. When I first started using my Samsung Meteor, it sounded like garbage and I had no idea why. I'm not sure if you could do this with all the other microphones, but I found out a way to change its settings from telephone quality, which is extremely horrible, to DVD quality, which is a lot better. For me, the microphone just came in telephone quality, and it might even come in this quality for a lot of you guys, so just make sure it's changed to the best quality. And also, if you're using something like the Blue Yeti, which has several different settings like cardioid mode, stereo mode, omnidirectional mode, and all these other modes, then just make sure you're using the right modes at the right times. Now let's move on to tip number two, make sure you're recording in a quiet environment. I often just close the windows, close the doors, turn off the fans, heaters, air conditioners, and only record when nobody else is at home. Don't worry too much about this tip because later in the video I'll show you how you can reduce your background noise by using Audacity, but try not to have people talking, a vacuum cleaner on, or a kid crying in the background. Tip number three, have a nice position for your microphone. You don't want to be too close to your mic because your audio will start clipping,
and you don't want to be too far from your mic, or then your mic won't pick up your vocals as good.
So try and find the best distance possible for your microphone so that your voice sounds clear and it doesn't cause clipping. I would say that you should stay at least a fist away from your mic and no more than 45 centimeters away from it. Moving on to tip number 4, if you don't have a windscreen for your mic, then just use socks instead. Yup, that's right, socks. For me, a pair of socks works the best, but it might be different for you guys. Just try experimenting with 1, 2, 3, and 4 socks and find out which one works best for you. Using socks has really helped me with making the audio sound much better because it gets rid of a lot of the unwanted noise that I don't want in my audio. Tip number 5, get rid of the echoes. You're gonna find out that echoes are going to be your biggest threat while recording. Many people buy these really expensive acoustic foams to get rid of echo, but you can simply use pillows that are in your house to get rid of the echoes in your voice. See, when you're recording at home, your voice gets a little echoey. Because if you haven't learned this at school, walls are conductors, meaning they reflect sound waves. So when you're recording, your mic picks up the vocals, but it also picks up the echoes made by the walls. And too much echo in your audio means that your audio is not good. Pillows, in contrast to walls, are insulators, meaning they stop sound waves from reflecting, meaning less echoes. I often put a pillow underneath my mic, a pillow behind the mic, and one on each side of the mic. Getting rid of all the echo in your voice will actually make your audio sound terrible because your voice will start to sound dry. But don't worry, pillows will always reflect a little bit of sound. Moving on to tip number 6, use a pop filter. Pop filters are not really that expensive and they really help with cleaning up and getting rid of the pops in your audio. I was too lazy to buy a pop filter, so I actually made one at home. It's really easy. You could do it too. Just get a metal hanger, bend it into a circle, and cover it with a sock. Moving on to tip number 7, try and find the perfect talking level for your microphone, because if you talk too loud in your microphone, then it may cause clipping, and if you talk too quiet in your videos, depending on your microphone, it won't really pick up your vocals as good. Tip number 8, if you feel like your microphone has some internal problems or if it's broken from inside or something, then make sure that you make the mic go through some basic troubleshooting.
Last but not least, tip number 9, if you don't have a microphone, then you should really save up for one. Yes, they cost money, but if you're serious about doing YouTube, then you need to be willing to make the purchases and the sacrifices.
Now I'll show you guys how to make your voice sound even better using this free audio editing software called Audacity. Download link in the description. So this is my pre-recorded audio. We're going to add effects to it and make it sound a lot better. And this is what it sounds like without any effects. If you guys haven't already, then make sure to subscribe to the channel and give this video a big thumbs up. It's pretty decent, but we're gonna add some effects to make it sound even better. So to start off, you want to leave 5 to 10 seconds of complete silence where you're not gonna say anything so your mic can pick up the background noise. Then you wanna select the background noise, head over to Effect, and then click on Noise Reduction. Now just copy my settings, which are Noise Reduction 24, Sensitivity 6, Frequency Smoothing 0, and Reduce. Then just click on Get Noise Profile, select all the audio, and hit Ctrl R if you're on Windows, and hit Command R if you're on Mac. This will get rid of the background noise. We can delete this bit here, and if you listen to our voice now. If you guys haven't already, then make sure to subscribe to the channel and give this video a big thumbs up. You'll hear that there's less background noise in it. Now what we're gonna do is add some equalization. Go over to Effect, hit Equalization, and here we're gonna add some bass to our voice. Now if you're a girl, you might want to skip this step because not many girls like to have their voices sound deeper, but at the end, it all just comes down to personal opinion. But anyways, you want to select bass boost, and at this part, it's really just your preference and how much bass you want to add to your audio. I usually keep it between 3 to 6 decibels, but with some people, you might want to add a little more or a little less depending on the type of voice you have. If you're not sure about how much bass you should add to your audio, then you can just hit the preview button and see what your audio sounds like. When you're done, just hit OK and you would see that your vocals have become a little thicker because of the bass. Now we're gonna head back to equalization again, and now we're gonna add some treble to our voice. So just select treble boost, and again, the same thing applies. It's all about what you prefer. Like for example, I don't like adding too much treble to my voice, so I'm just gonna keep it really low. This is what my audio sounds like without equalization. If you guys haven't already, then make sure to subscribe to the channel and give this video a big thumbs up. And this is what my audio sounds like with equalization. If you guys haven't already, then make sure to subscribe to the channel and give this video a big thumbs up. As you can see, after I've added the bass boost and the treble boost, my audio sounds so much more better, and now it's more listenable. Now we're gonna add some compression to our audio. So just head over to Effect, hit Compressor, and over here, I don't really mess with the settings because I think that they're perfectly fine, so we're just gonna hit OK. This is what my audio sounds like without equalization and compression. If you guys haven't already, then make sure to subscribe to the channel and give this video a big thumbs up. And this is what my audio sounds like with equalization and compression. If you guys haven't already, then make sure to subscribe to the channel and give this video a big thumbs up. As you can see, now it's a lot better and a lot more optimized for listening. Now we're almost done with the tutorial, but I just want to say a couple more things. If you feel like you said something a little too fast or a little too slow, and you don't want to record again, then you can go over to Effect and click on Change Tempo to change your talking speed. If you feel like you can hear really loud breaths in your audio and it's just getting a little annoying, then just select all the bits where you can hear a loud breath sound and click on this tool here called Silence Tool. Then, I like to amplify the audio a little bit before I export the audio, and to do that, just go over to Effect, hit on Amplify, and over here, I just hit OK. I don't really mess with these settings here, because if you do, it would cause clipping and stuff, and you don't want that in your audio. If you don't know how to export your audio, then just go over to File and hit Export Audio. And the last thing I like to do is put my audio in this app called Levelator. Download link in the description. It's completely free, and what it does is that it adjusts the audio levels within the audio so that everything is the exact same volume. This is what my audio sounds like without any of the effects. If you guys haven't already, then make sure to subscribe to the channel and give this video a big thumbs up. And this is what my audio sounds like with equalization, compression, and I'm just gonna call it levelation. If you guys haven't already, then make sure to subscribe to the channel and give this video a big thumbs up. And that's it. How to make your microphone sound professional. If you guys liked the video, then be sure to hit the like button. Hit the subscribe button if you want more videos like this every single week. If you know anything else that makes your mic sound even more professional that I haven't mentioned in this video, then make sure to tell us in the comments below. If you're demotivated and you're looking for some motivation to continue YouTube, then make sure to check out this video here. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching this video till the very end. I really do appreciate it. And I shall see you in my next video. Fucking.